Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to a new video. And today I've got Lego Mindstorm robot to show you guys. So if you probably know, you probably know that there's a huge trend at the time I'm recording this video, which is the trend of the fidget spinner. Now, I got myself a fidget spinner a few days ago, and if you haven't checked the video out in which I unboxed it, go ahead and do so. But I was thinking if I could take this to the next level and make a fidget spinner in Lego Mindstorms, and I've done just that. So this is my fidget spinner. Well, yeah, this is my fidget spinner. I mean, it doesn't really particularly look like one, although I think it's fine. You know, that's probably the best I could do with Lego Mindstorms. I couldn't really make it as compact as this one. Okay, there's a big size difference. But anyways, so if I go and play the program for this, I can press the button over here on my thing, and this will move forward. I mean, it's the spin. Yay, I've got myself a fidget spinner! Woohoo! Fidget spinner that I can hang. And a fidget spinner that breaks if I hang it. But that's kind of what it is. And you can probably take a look at the main body of it. So there's this wheel over here connected to this, rod, and two motors, which I was thinking of spinning, but of course, when this thing is spinning, the wire would get stuck, so I couldn't do that. But then when it spins and when it stops, these things are still spinning. So, you know, it gives like a good ending to the fidget spinner. But otherwise I've just got a motor connected to my box. And then if I actually so if the battery gets over, that's the only time it's gonna stop, unless you take your hand off. So it's like an infinite fidget spinner. You know, seriously, even if they made like a fidget spinner that spins on forever, it will still end when the world ends. But that is the fastest a Mindstorm thing can go. And then you can do like cool tricks like throw it up and catch it. You do that and then you can throw it up and catch it again. Up and catch it. You can again swing it like that. So you can swing it upside down. And you can take off the spinner on the top and you can just spin the motor. So those are the properties of the fidget spinner. And if I were to talk about what a teacher told us in chemistry class, this fidget spinner seems like it's a solid. Mm-hmm. It has definite volume and definite mass, like all solids do. It's not compressible. Okay, anyways. But yes, guys, that is going to be it for the fidget spinner. But other than that, I think, rather than using that fidget spinner, I'll just use this one. See? It's much better. Oh well, hope you enjoyed the video, guys. If you did, make sure to subscribe, like the video, share it with your friends and family, because the last video I posted, the Ice Bucket Challenge for the 100th video special, got 300 views in one day. I know, I just checked on my computer right now. Okay, 294 views in one day. That's a lot. But yeah, go check it out. Go check that Ice Bucket Challenge video out if you haven't already. But that is going to be it for the fidget spinner Lego Mindstorm video. And leave a comment, share it with your friends, family. But that is going to be it. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.